Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. And for today's video, I will be sharing with you the things that I learned in starting a business. By the way, I'm wearing a shirt from Hey Reminder, and as usual, it's oversized and it's so comfy. Ganda ng message, you are enough. So first of all, we can't deny the fact that this pandemic really made us consider starting our own business. And with that being said, it means more competition because halos lahat tayo tinatry pumasok sa market. That is where the challenge begins. Disclaimer lang guys, hindi ako expert. I am not yet successful and I am a beginner. Hindi ako nag-graduate ng business course and I did not take any short course that's related to business. And so everything that I will share with you is based on my personal experience only, and please take it with a grain of salt. So before we start, what are the type of businesses? So number one, we have sole proprietorship. So this means na ikaw lang yung may-ari ng brand or ng business mo. And then there's partnership, corporation, limited liability company. Ano pa ba? There's non-profit. So there are a lot of types of businesses out there. I am not going to discuss each and every one of them here because that is not the purpose of this video. But I just wanna share it to you guys para at least kung gusto niyo mag-research, then you can learn about those as well. Okay, so next naman, what are the kinds of businesses that you can start? Nung una, akala ko when it comes to business, iisang bagay lang siya. But then I realized na when you go out of your house, everything around you is a business. So iba-iba siya. And each type of business has its pros and cons. So number one, we have the essentials. Ito yung mga food, groceries, water stations, yung mga bagay na kailangan talaga ng tao. I think the biggest pro of this one is it's an essential. So ibig sabihin, meron at meron kang magiging customers kasi kailangan ka ng tao. So next, we have the services such as car wash, laundry, beauty services like yung mga parlor, yung mga ganon. And then there's also creative services wherein you can offer your skills to design for other people. We also have buy and sell, and this one is actually a good business kasi hindi mo na siya masyadong kailangan pag-isipan or paggastusan ng mga marketing kasi literal na ibebenta mo lang na ibebenta yung mga binibili mo. An example of this is buy and sell ng cars. So, di ba kapag nagbabuy and sell ka naman ng car, hindi mo na siya masyadong kailangan pag-isipan ng promotions kasi hahanap ka lang talaga ng buyer. Next naman, we have the passive income. So, ito yung mga business na hindi mo na siya kailangan pagtrabahuhan araw-araw. Ito yung kind ng business na kahit tulog ka, pwede kang kumita. Example of this is yung mga apartment rentals, Airbnbs, real estate. And I think yung pinaka-con lang talaga nito is kailangan mo ng malaking puhunan para dito. But the biggest pro is ang property kasi hindi siya nawawala and palaki lang ng palaki yung value niya. So if mag-i-invest ka ng malaki, for sure malaki din yung balik sa'yo. And then lastly, we have the businesses out of hobbies or passion. So with this one naman, I think yung pinaka-con kasi dito is hindi ka sure kung meron ka agad makukuha ng market or hindi mo alam kung magki-click ba agad siya sa mga tao. Sometimes it's not easy to target the right customers for the products or the services that you sell kasi nga ang hobby very personal kasi siya. So minsan hindi ganun kadaling mahanap yung mga tao na magiging interesado dun sa services na ino-offer natin. So there, before I start with the lessons, I just want to quickly share the businesses that I have para you guys have an idea kung bakit ito yung mga learnings na natutunan ko all throughout the process. Okay, so the first one we have Agos. It's wear.agos on Instagram. So it's a sustainable brand and I am aiming to offer and provide sustainable products to you guys. Next is Activo Manila. So from the word itself, it's a fitness brand and we are selling fitness apparel and fitness accessories. So with Activo Manila, apat kami may-ari nito. So I think it's considered as a corporation or a partnership. So yung kasama ko dito is si JN and two of our close friends. So next one, we have Cocina ni Pau and Cocina ni Puto. But with this one, wala akong kahit anong ownership dito. This is my brother's business and I'm just helping him out with social media, and community management. Kasi Nani Pao is a food business, so we sell pastries, and hopefully we can turn it into a restaurant soon. Okay, and then yung Kusina ni Puto naman is a pet treat store, so this is super close to my heart kasi you guys know how much I love dogs and how much I love animals. So yun, hope you guys can check it out, and please support our small businesses. Finally, moving on to the lessons that I learned. So number one, it's not going to be easy. Starting a business is not as simple as creating an Instagram account. It's more than that. As in, kailangan mo talaga siyang pag-effortan, kailangan mo mag-research, you have to know the market, and you have to know everything about it. Otherwise, there's a big possibility that your brand and your business is not going to be successful. It's not easy, especially if you're starting your brand with no connections, no investors, no capital, no background. As in, if you're building it from scratch, then it's not going to be easy, but for sure it's going to be worth it as long as you put your heart into it. So number two, you have to be patient when it comes to finding the right suppliers. So guys, sobrang daming suppliers, but not all of them will be the perfect fit for you kasi magkakaiba pa rin naman tayo eh. Sometimes it's as simple as how the supplier talks to you. Minsan kasi talaga nakaka-apekto yun. So, you really have to be patient. You can't settle for a supplier na pwede na kasi it will reflect on the product that you will sell. So, if you're not 100% happy with your products, then there's a big chance that your customers are not going to be happy with it as well. And also guys, mayroong mga supplier na magaling lang mag-sample, pero when it comes to mass production, hindi na maganda yung quality ng gawa nila. So of course, being a small business owner or being a startup business owner, as much as possible, ayaw natin magsayang ng pera. Okay, number three, there will be paperwork. And yes, with this one, I mean yung mga business permit, yung mga legal matters, meron at meron ganun ang lahat ng business. And you have to be knowledgeable when it comes to this, meaning you have to do your research. But of course, if you're still starting, then you don't have to do it right away because you have to test the performance of your brand and also your commitment to it. Kasi sayang naman if ipaparegister mo yung business mo, tapos in the long run, hindi mo naman pala matututukan. And as far as I know, mas mahal mag-close ng business kesa sa pag-a-apply. So number four, you have to be the first influencer for your brand or your business. And I know na minsan nakakahiya siya, but guys, kayo yung unang tao dapat na napopromote and napoplog ng business nyo kasi walang gagawa nun para sa inyo. It doesn't matter if you feel like wala namang nakikinig, wala namang napofollow, but you still have to do it. Kahit nakakahiya, kahit minsan parang ang annoying na kung araw-araw pinopromote mo to. But minsan kasi, when we're constantly provided with information, minsan nagkakaroon siya ng recall or subconsciously tumatatak siya sa isip natin. So imagine what that can do to your brand kung yung mga followers mo parang tumatatak na sa utak nila kung ano ba yung mga pinagsasabi mo, di ba? And plus points if you can ask your family and friends to do it too para nakikita rin ng followers and friends nila yung brand mo. And you never know because that can turn into a sale. So please don't be shy. Alisin niyo yung hiya and promote your brand and business every day. So number five, this is so important. You have to know your brand's why or your brand's purpose. Sometimes it's okay if yung style mo when it comes to your business is spontaneous, but it's really a big help if before mong simulan lahat, you establish your brand's vision para at least along the way you won't get lost. Knowing your brand's purpose will set you apart, but it doesn't always mean that it has to be a competition because sometimes having a business means being a part of a community. And this is actually my vision for Agos. I don't really aim for it to be the top and I don't really want to be a part of such a competitive community. I want to be a part of a community na lahat nagtutulungan. And yung vision ko kasi talaga for Agos is for it to become a part of the sustainable movement. To explain this further, me personally as a consumer, hindi naman ako nag-stick sa isang brand over and over again. I usually look for multiple brands with the same purpose. Kasi gusto ko mag-support ng madaming brands na same yung vision. And believe me guys, maraming community na ganito na ang aim nila is maghilahan pataas. So ayun, as much as possible, try to find a community that will lift you up rather than pull you down kasi they're all about making money. So last but not the least, starting a business is really a trial and error process. It's a learning process and it's normal to make mistakes and fail along the way. And you will never know kung tama or mali yung ginagawa mo if you're not going to start. So just go for it and take every lesson with you as you move forward. Don't be afraid of making mistakes and failing kasi it's a part of life and it's part of the process when it comes to business. Wala namang business na perfect agad sa simula or wala namang business na walang errors. So if you fail, then just keep going kasi dun ka matututo, dun magiging strong yung brand mo kapag natutunan mo na kung ano yung mga dapat ginagawa and yung dapat hindi ginagawa for your business. So that's it for today's video. If you are planning to start or if you already have a business, then I would love to support you. Please leave your business name in the comments down below so anyone who comes across this video can also check it out. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and I'll see you on my next one. Bye!